Good morning, and thanks for joining us on another Sandia Mountain Natural History Center Quick Trip. Today, we're going to do something a little bit different. We're starting here at the Museum of Natural History and Science, and we're going to be traveling to the top of the mountain. And the reason we're going to do that is we're going to look at how elevation affects temperature, humidity, and the plants that grow on the mountain. Because we know the weather has a major impact on ecosystems, and this is one way that we can look at it and actually see it. So let's get started. So we'll be using a GPS and a Kestrel weather meter to measure the elevation and the temperature. And what we'll do is every 1,000 feet or so, we will stop and we will check the elevation and the temperature. So we are starting at 4,667 feet with a temperature about 82.2. All right, we've headed up further up the mountain. Now we are at the Sandia Mountain Natural History Center, about 6,848 feet above sea level. And our temperature is now 75.9. We did make a stop in Carnuel, 1,000 feet above the museum, and the temperature there was 80.8. So as we're climbing, the temperature is going down. So as we climb up the mountain and the temperature drops and the humidity rises, we can also see that we have a shift in plants. Here at the Sandia Mountain Natural History Center, we've got oaks, junipers, and pinyon is our primary plants. We'll see if that changes the higher we go. So now we are at 9,042 feet. And things have changed pretty dramatically. You can see a change in the trees. We've got aspens and New Mexico locusts, as well as some white firs. Our temperature is down to 70.8, and our humidity is all the way up to 31.6. So as we go higher in the mountain, we're seeing that dropping of the temperature, rising of the humidity, and it's definitely having an impact on the plants. Let's go see what it's like at the top.
Just kidding.
So we've made it to the top. The elevation where I'm standing is 10,483 feet above sea level. Our temperature is 68.5 and our humidity is 28.2. So we can see that there's a major change as we go up the mountain. So I hope our trip up the mountain made it clear why it's important to study weather and climate. Just a few degrees of change as we went up the mountain had a major impact on the plants that live there. And if you change the plants, obviously the animals are going to be affected as well. So we are studying the weather every day here at the Sandia Mountain Natural History Center. We want to study the climate. We also want to be aware of fire danger and things like that. And also, it just helps us prepare for our outdoor programs each day. If you want to study weather, you don't need a big weather station like this. All you need is a thermometer and a rain gauge and maybe a notebook, and that'll get you started. But speaking of weather, looks like we got a storm rolling in, and I better get out of here. Join us next time for our next quick trip. Today, you saw me using a GPS to determine our elevation, but you don't need to get that high tech. Really, all you need to do is download off of our website our Life Zones activity, put that together with our Tree Key activity, and the trees will tell you what life zone you're at. By just knowing the trees, for example, we have a pinyon tree right here, so looking at our sheet. We know that pinyon trees grow between 6,000 and 7,000 feet. So that's another quick, easy way that you can get weather and nature and the trees to tell you what your elevation is.